And now a case of a horrific crime here in Mumbai, where a 29-year-old Railway Police Force constable has been arrested for allegedly raping a cab driver on the railway premises near CSMT station in Mumbai. On the night of 11th January, the constable, allegedly in an inebriated condition, asked the driver to take him to a red light area in South Mumbai. When the driver refused to do so, since he said that he was preoccupied with another customer, the constable hit him with a stick and empty beer bottles. He then dragged the cab driver to a corner of that location and raped him. He later fled the spot after robbing the victim of his money and the cab keys as well as his mobile phone. The constable is now in judicial custody until the 20th of January. So Disha Shah is tracking the story for us. She's brought all the information. She's right now on that location, I believe, where this incident occurred. So Disha, if you can first tell us how exactly things happened. Was this RPF constable on duty? What exactly took place in the location that you're standing right now? Just take us through the details, please.
Well, that's right, Afrida. This is the exact spot and location where the taxi driver was raped by the RPF constable, for that matter. If I can just show you around this location, this is Karnak Bandar, very close to the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj terminus area, for that matter. It is hardly 200 to 300 meter away. What we know so far, Afrida, after speaking to the cops, the bench that you see, this is where the 29-year-old RPF constable Amit Dhankan, he was sitting here at the bench after finishing his duty from 4 p.m. to 11:30 p.m. That was his shift for that night, is what we understand. As soon as he saw one of the taxi driver, here where the white car that you see, which is being parked, at that same location, there was a taxi which was parked. The taxi driver was present inside. In fact, he was waiting for the passengers, as it was an cab aggregator based taxi. He was waiting for the passengers, for that matter. At that point in time, the constable, right from there, he walked up to the taxi driver and asked him to drop him at the Grand Road area, which is very close by, which is 2 to 3 kilometers away from this particular location. The taxi driver here refused to take him to Grand Road, as he had already booked a ride for someone else. After that, what happened? Then started the horrific crime here, Afrida.
Okay.
Once he refused to do so, he dragged the taxi driver outside and he started hurling abuses. He even beat him with the wooden stick and whatever possible things he could find nearby at this point in time. Then later, the passengers who really had booked the cab, they arrived, and as they saw that both the men were fighting, they left. They cancelled the ride and they left. So this is exactly the same location. This is a railway quarters that you see, railway premises quarters. After the taxi driver was brutally thrashed with wooden stick, the constable went ahead and raped him. Here you can see at this juncture in the night, it happened between 11:50 p.m. to 2 a.m. Afrida.
Okay.
So here in all of this area, there are trucks which are parked, and he was raped exactly at this particular location where we are taking you right now.
Okay.
So this is exactly happened. The assault happened for 2 hours. He was stripped as well. He was robbed.
Okay.
850 rupees cash was taken by the constable. In fact, after 2 a.m. only, the victim here in concern, the taxi driver, the 43-year-old taxi driver, managed to fled the spot. And then he actually reached the MRA Mark police station, which is hardly 3 minutes away from this particular location.
Okay, so as of now, Disha, the accused has been arrested.
So this is exactly how it happened, Afrika.
Yes, yes. And a couple of things extremely worrying. Of course, this is again another case of a protector turning predator. This is an RPF constable, a railway protection force that he works for. Was this misusing of his uniform to intimidate and assault a cab driver? And you said the assault went on for 2 hours. Why was there no intervention from anybody around? Disha, we'll come back to you for more inputs. Thanks for now.